Here at airbedsforless.com, we are committed in keeping you satisfied with your airbed purchase. We have conducted our own research and found that about 80% of all airbed problems are from accidental puncture. Please allow me a few minutes and I will show you how to patch your airbed properly so that it will continue to be a great product for years to come. Over the years, we've had a lot of air mattresses come back to us that don't even have any problems. So how do you know if your air mattress has a puncture or if it's perfectly fine? Let me walk you through a few troubleshooting ideas that will let you know if your air mattress needs a patch or if it's perfectly fine. Like all inflatable products, air mattresses will lose a little air if there's a temperature change, mainly at night when the furnace kicks off. The air inside the air mattress will get colder. There's really no way to prevent this from happening unless you get a space heater, maybe put it next to the air mattress from a safe distance. What that'll do is keep the air inside nice and warm and keep your guests nice and comfortable. When air mattresses are brand new, they can stretch up to 5 inches. So make sure you allow sufficient time for your air mattress to stretch out completely before your first use. If you don't allow stretching, it may seem like it's getting soft when really it's just stretching out. So how do you know if your air mattress is punctured? Well, take a look. Your air mattress should never lose this much air. If you're sinking down this much, there's a good chance you have a puncture. So sit back and let us help you find the hole and fix it right. When trying to find out where the air mattress is punctured, I always suggest starting at the bottom. We found that the majority of all airbed punctures happen on the bottom. This can be because you inflate it in an office area where there might be staples or slivers even embedded into the carpet. So what I first suggest doing is get your ear 2 to 3 inches away from the air mattress and simply listen for a slow air leak. If that doesn't work, go ahead and lick your lips and get moisture on them and scan it again 2 to 3 inches away from the air mattress, trying to feel any cold air coming from the bed. I find that those two steps are usually enough to find the hole. If you're certain that the puncture is not on the bottom, then continue with those two strategies on the sides and even the top of the air mattress. If your air mattress is punctured on any area where the flocking material is at, you'll need to get a soft wire brush or sandpaper and strip this flocking off of the air mattress. How you do that is deflate the air mattress, get the surface nice and wet where the patch is going, and then simply scrub it away from the vinyl. Now you need to make sure the flocking is completely off of the air mattress where the patch is going so that that patch can seal nice and tight and securely to the airbed. The items that are needed to prepare your air mattress for the patch are a pair of scissors, your patch kit, a 10-pound or heavier weight, diluted all-purpose cleaner, and a towel. Try to stay away from paper towels as you scrub the air mattress. It may leave some fibers behind and it won't secure the patch tightly. So the first thing we want to do to prepare the air mattress for the patch is clean the surface. Take some all-purpose cleaner that's highly diluted. We just need enough chemical in there to remove any oils or dirt. Just lightly spray the surface where the patch is going to be going and scrub it dry with your towel, making sure that the entire patch area is completely dry. Now what you'll want to do is take one of your patches and cut a circle patch that's big enough to cover where the puncture is. I have a small hole, so I went about an inch tall all the way around there. And I'm going to show you how to patch with the adhesive glue. So what you do is you take the glue that comes with the patch, flip the cap around, just puncture it here. Okay. And I like to go heavy on the glue. And I just make sure that the center where the hole is has plenty of glue, And I just spread this around so the entire surface of the patch has glue on it. Now it might spill out the sides, we might have too much, but that's a good thing. Then what we want to do is take the patch and lay it over the punctured area. Push down on it, make sure that that glue gets a nice seal. Okay, once we've laid the patch, I've got glue coming out the sides. That's a little too much, but that's what I want. Then what we're gonna do is take your weight and we're gonna set it on there. Now most people recommend at least 2 hours before inflation. I would say at least 6 to 8 hours before you use the air mattress again. And that will ensure that the patch is there to stay.